Hey everyone, I'm making this video, one more video, and it's because I had a dream around August. It was around that time, August 2020, I had this dream. I believe the dream is somewhat prophetic, or is prophetic, but I cannot make that claim, you understand? Because time will tell. There is many of us Christians who are in this end times, because we are in the end times, where there was a time when I was saying we were entering the end times, but now we are literally in the end times. And whoever is not able to discern that, then you need to check yourself. But this is literally the end times. And you know that there has been watchmen appointed for this time. You could say that you are heading in and you are beginning your training, and soon you'll be deployed for missions, you understand? But this time right now, I believe, is a time of preparation for all Christians, that we should be preparing for the days ahead. That's what I truly believe. And as a watchman, I sound the horn and I let you people know that this time right now means business, people. You know, it's time to get serious, and it's time to understand the seriousness or the severity of the times that we have just entered a couple days ago. Now, with that said, next thing I want to say before I tell you the dream is, for every prophet out there, remember, people, when we read the word of God, there's always, always a chapter that tells you from A, B, C, and D, you can be a prophet, right? Don't let that get to your head. Because we, as Christians in general, have to be very careful, right? Because the life of another human being depends on us. And that is a very serious task. If we say something we're not supposed to be saying, well, that basically means that there will be a soul out there that can possibly be lost, and you now have blood on your hands. So when we speak, we need to be mindful that God has entrusted us with his sheep. And that is a very serious thing. And what I'm saying is that if you think about God and you really do know perhaps a little bit of him, you really do know him, right? You will know that as a Christian, right, your mission becomes to gather souls for the kingdom. That is a very heavy mission, people. But sometimes I think people don't sit down to process this. Let me say this again. Once you become a Christian and you're saved, good for you, right? Your soul is now saved. There are some Christians out there, right, that believe that because they're saved, that is it. And that's not it. And if you're okay with that, okay, then you're okay with that. You're going to watch over your soul and your soul alone. But remember that what Jesus died for, he dies for us sinners, and his main mission throughout the earth is just to make sure that no one perishes. So in that sense, what I'm trying to tell you is that if you now deny yourself, carry the cross and follow him, his mission becomes your mission. And I'm not sure if this is correct, but I believe that Jesus' mission, his sole purpose is to save souls. So you as a Christian now have this responsibility to also collect souls for the kingdom of heaven. And the mission is very important. But if you really do think, and now I'm talking about prophets out there, right? Because this can make the difference between you doing a great job and keeping your soul, or between you doing a great job and losing your soul, right? Because we have to answer for things at the end, right? And I'm saying this to myself, but I'm not perfect. Once again, I have made mistakes and things like that. But I choose to take responsibility, yeah? And I just don't want to be responsible for losing a soul. And I want to take it seriously. I don't want to take any chances. So a little bit about me now, so you can have a little bit intel. I don't like speaking. I'm a very shy person. I don't like talking much, and I don't like, especially don't like putting myself out here, making videos or doing these things. Like, if you look at my YouTube channel, I'm not famous. Nobody knows me. That's cool. I enjoy making these little videos of things I buy and posting it out there. Whether or not it gets viewed or not, I just enjoy doing it. So that's what I was into. But in the midst of all of this, right, I start having dreams. And the first time I had a vision, there's a difference between a vision and a dream. I feel like now is the time for me to tell. I was not saved. I was pretty much sinning when I first encountered a vision. I was in a park hanging out with a friend, middle of the day in New York City, and I was taken in a vision. And I really do not know anyone else, because it's like, you know, you can look at old videos, as much videos as you possibly can. It's still not going to help you when you have an experience yourself and you're like totally mind blown by it. And you like have absolutely just, it's just, I can't put it in words. You understand? So when I first had this vision, I was sinning. I'm not going to tell you my sin or what I was doing, but I was sinning. I can tell you that much. But God gave me this vision. So that is crucial, because it lets you know that there's so many out there that really, really, really expect you to be perfect. Like, you don't have the possibility, all right, of being a human and making errors and mistakes. Or God got you when you were perfect. That's not real. There's no way that any of us can be perfect. Like, every single human being, even the 12 apostles, has something that made them human. They were not perfect. Understand? They're human beings and they're sinners. But when God gets a hold of you, the sin becomes easier to deny. That's as far as it gets, people. It does not mean you will suddenly become perfect, because that is unreal. Now, that is the first thing, and I feel like you people, because you're listening to my videos, you need to know that. And I needed to say that. So yeah, that's basically my first experience. I was sinning like crazy. Ooh, sinning, I'm telling you. And God just got me like that. And I didn't need anything else to know. I already knew God was real. I already believed in God. And I already also believe in Jesus. I've always been a child since I was small. Since I can recall, God is it for me. But I know God, you understand, since the beginning. But that does not mean that throughout my life journey that I didn't bear off. My mother baptized me when I was a baby, and I have not been baptized till this day. Something that I need to do. Something that I want to do. But it just haven't happened for me. And I know that as long as I don't make that step, you know, I'm in danger. And that's just how I feel. That's how I want to feel. Because I want to feel like, you know, nothing is set on stone until the end. And to say the least, people, you can be saved today. That doesn't necessarily put your name on stone so that you'll be saved tomorrow, right? It's possible that things happen, and I'm telling you, things happen. So wisdom truly and really will be for you to live life as if you have to save yourself daily. Not sure where I'm getting at with this. I just feel like I need to say it. So be mindful. And if God has chosen you to have dreams and vision, remember again, who we are working for, we're working for Him. All right, so He gives her a dream, He gives you a word. Remember, He is giving it to you. And you are to deliver it as He give it to you. But apart from that, He chooses whether or not what you're saying will come to pass, or if what you're saying was just to stir up things somewhere in a place. For you, it's not important. For Him, He knows exactly what He's doing and why. However, we also have an enemy. And this is why we need to be mindful. Because the enemy, right, is going to do everything in his power to stop you from delivering. And that's that. And if you say to yourself that you don't have an enemy, then you're in for a rude awakening. I can tell you that much, because we do have an enemy, and he's very active. Yes, you are with God. He is all powerful, the creator of everything. But nonetheless, the enemy is also real. Anyways, the dream goes like this. If you have been outside of the United States to perhaps the Caribbean, right? You will realize that around 10, 9, 8, 7, perhaps 12, it all depends on the neighborhood. People will gather outside of their homes in the streets. You know, you could have a group of people, neighbors, spending time with each other. You can see a group of people out in their balcony talking. Some people out literally sitting down with tables on the streets, playing cards, playing dominoes, playing games. You can see another group of people out in the street again, so sitting down somewhere on the sidewalk, just playing and having fun. I walk around. I see the houses and the doors are open. You can walk in to any house, and it's no problem because you're part of the neighborhood and pretty much everybody knows each other, right? So I am in the dream now, and what I'm seeing in front of me is that street that I just mentioned. I see the streets. I know that it's night and I see people all over the street. It was a lot of people. It felt that I was part of the people. I was part of the community. And this is just sorry, got cut off there. But anyways, this is going to be a long video and I apologize for it, but I had to get everything out. It seemed like in the dream, what it was trying to basically allow me to do was to look around and recognize that it's a regular night on Earth. And everybody is just doing what they usually do, right? However, I was taken now from the streets over to a hill. And I look up and I see to my left and to my right. And I'm seeing basically woods, trees. It had the representation of fall, when the leaves are falling. As a matter of fact, no, winter, because most of the leaves were already off the tree. I think I pay attention to that. And I look up and I see that the path which I am to follow goes upward somewhere, and it felt like I was heading towards a mountain. So I'm heading up, but I stop and I look up in the sky, and I look in. If I'm standing like this right now, I look this way. That is my left. I look up towards my left. And I saw this. Now I'm going to show you a drawing. All right, so let's pretend that this is the path. And I'm going up towards a hill. And there's woods, you know, around here. Woods. I see to my left and to my right is woods, and I'm going up a path, and this is me, right? Let's pretend this is me. I'm facing this direction. So I'm facing forward. And this is important because I think that if anything is important in this ring, it's perhaps these things. And then I look up. So this little dot is me. Imagine that I'm standing there. And I look up and I look towards my left, right? And I'm looking at the sky. And in the sky, there's a formation of planes. And just like how you see it here, it's a pyramid. It's a pyramid. Every single space, these little dots are basically planes. Or yet. And they're all taking the space. They're in a pyramid formation going in this direction. So if they pass me, they will be going in this direction, right? All right, so I saw the formation of the plane, right? And it came from that direction, which I showed you. When I looked at it, I knew exactly what it was, and I said, three times I yell, it is here, it is here, it is here. When I said those words and repeated those words in my mind, what I'm saying to, like, my understanding is that the time is now here. It is basically it. It has begun, and it has begun for quite a long time now, right? But now the time is literally here, now, present, this very moment. It is it. That's what I got when I said and repeated and saw the planes. The planes now are in the way that the planes look like yet. Yet, I'm sorry, I'm very bad at pronouncing words, but yet, J-E-T. But it also look like pyramid. So the planes themselves look like, had the formation of a pyramid. And I think that is important because it could be a F-117 jet plane, or it could be a F-2 bomber. And for some reason, I am mentioning that because I just felt like even that was important. But that's that. Now I find my, I'm still in the hill, right? And I look up in the sky again. But this time I look towards this direction. And I'm going to show you in the paper. All right, so once again, this is me. The plane came from here. They passed through here. And when they pass, as I'm looking at them, I say three times, it is time, it is, you know. Then I look towards this direction of the sky, right? And I see these things coming down from the sky. What is this? I'm good at drawing, but I don't know why I'm so terrible right now. These are meteors. If I saw balls of fire, rocks with fire coming down from the sky in this direction. They were coming down, but from this direction, and they were going straight down to the earth. And when I saw those meteors, those rock of fire coming down from the sky, I said three times, the fallen has fallen. The fallen has fallen. The fallen has fallen. And when I was saying that, I just felt like those were evil spirit, demonic spirit that have fallen onto the earth and now were able to do things that they were not able to do before. It's like a whole new level. So they are literally now on the earth, walking on the earth. And if before they care to not be seen, now they don't care. It's like an open concept that there is demons walking the earth, and it's like it's a normal thing. I don't know, but that's not what I was getting when I was saying that. You know, it's like there's literally demons now on the earth, and they came from the sky, and they have fallen, and they're here on the earth. Anyways, after the meteors fell, and I said what I said, obviously to me, it just feels like those meteoroids were not really meteoroids. I'm sorry, I do not know how to spell these things well. But they were just fallen demonic spirit. That's what I got. Anyways, I looked up again, right? And let me show you. Now the meteoroids fell from this direction. And they fell down straight to the earth, right? But then I saw a star. I saw many stars, many tiny little stars, but I saw a very big star. And I knew what this star was. But when I saw it, I said three times again, the dragon is here. The dragon is here. The dragon is here. I saw the star. And it kind of came from that direction, the same direction as the meteoroid. And it came straight down to the earth. And when I saw the star, I automatically associated the star with the dragon. And then I said, the dragon is here. And now when I said that, I was taken back from the mountain to one moment. So yeah, when I said that the dragon is here, I was taken from the mountain back to the streets where I was before I was taken to the mountains. And now things were different. Now I saw empty streets, and I saw like if, you know, someone has just come and taken people away to one area, and they were gathering people there. And as I thought it, so it was. I started walking the streets and I saw, I was able to see down somewhere, right? And I saw a gathering of people there. What seemed to be like, perhaps, you know, a parking lot that they have turned into this like camp. You see how you see right now, you have that COVID testing sites that you go over there, they prepare these sites and you're able to go almost in any parking lot. Just like that is how it looked, but it was much, much bigger. And it was clear. There was only one tent. And then there was this place where they have people line up. And I see that the line is heading to this one place, right? And for some reason, as I'm looking down, I was able to see inside the place. And inside the place, there was two women waiting for whoever comes in, right? These women were dressed in white. And they had, basically, there was a pool in there or a fall that basically was like water, like a little river part in a place. And there was this white, bluish, liquid water looking thing coming down into the pool, right? It looked like a waterfall, right? Into the pool. And it was a whitish, bluish glow to the water. And everybody who entered there now, once they go into the pool, I realize they come out, and they come out dressing in white, but they don't come out the same. And I'm looking at them, right? And I'm saying to myself, what has happened? There's a switch and something has really changed. But in my mind, I'm saying to myself, I know what this is. Whoever goes into that pool does not come out the same. And when they come out, I say to myself, it is good for my self-safety that I understand that once someone goes into that pool, they don't come out the same. They're no longer the same person. And for my own safety, I need to recognize that if I have a loved one who has gone there and come out, and for my safety, I need to know that they are no longer the same person. As a matter of fact, it does not seem like they are a human being once they come out of that water. And all of these things is just my thoughts that is happening in a dream as I'm looking down and seeing what's going on, right? So I start now thinking about someone who I left at the street before they took me to the mountain. Somebody important to me. So I start secretly moving, very quiet, because I understand what's happening, but at the same time, I'm discovering what's happening. Start moving very, very quietly. I start lurking around the streets, going into places, looking for the person, hoping that this person was not collected yet and has not gone down there where people are going into this pool and coming out different. Anyways, I go into this house. I'm looking out the window. I'm still looking at the people and the gathering over there. And then I feel like somebody has just opened the door. And it turned out that two women dressed in white came after me. So they're looking for me and they're looking for anybody who is hiding. And I say to myself, there is no place to hide, truly and honestly. And now I'm going to have to be always on the move and always on the walk and always in discretion or discreet, being discreet, because I am like somewhat, you know, on the run and alone. I feel alone, but I don't feel alone at the same time. I just feel alone because I don't have any humans around me. But I know that I'm not alone because I know God is with me. It's just how I feel in the dream, right? Anyways, and I know exactly what is happening according to the dream. I feel as if I know exactly what is happening. Anyways, I go now. Because these two women came in the house, I jump out the window to escape from them. And I fall into water. And I'm hiding and trying to, you know, find my way out. But then they find me again, the same two women. And now one of them raises their right hand at me. She raises her hand like this, and she basically directs it towards me. And out of the palm of her hand came a beam of blue and white light and came towards me. And she shot two times, but whatever she shot at me didn't work. That beam of light that she shot at me did not work. And I knew that the reason why it didn't work is because I was under the protection of the Holy Spirit. And God was with me. And I knew that whatever was happening, whatever this thing, this woman looking like thing who was firing at me was not truly a human being. So whatever she was firing at me had no power over me because God was with me. And then from there, I was taken out to some other place where I see complete and utter disaster, wickedness and darkness, all sorts of things happening in the world where it just felt like a world without law. And because I believe I know a little bit of the truth, I won't claim to know it all. I know or knew exactly what was happening in the dream. And I knew it's just the end of times. And that was the dream. It seems like a lot, but that was it. I had this dream on September. It was almost September, so probably like the last day. I did not write it down or pay attention much, but because of what I see happening now and today, I just feel like, you know, it's important for me to share because of the simple fact that the Bible has to be fulfilled, and just the very same way that Jesus had to be sacrificed for our sins, so will the word of God be fulfilled, because the word was fulfilled back then when Jesus was sacrificed. Then so will the word be fulfilled now in the end times. So the lava, and I'm starting to probably sound a little bit crazy, but the volcanoes and the lava is a sign of the multiplying of the mornings of the earth. So in other words, volcanoes are a crucial sign of the times. And whenever they erupt, then take it as a sign that crime and all of this wickedness is going to, and also not the wickedness itself, but natural events, you know, of destruction is going to become more and more and more and more. So you sometimes, if you think about it just like that, you become a little bit like discouraged. But again, that is, it is written, and the end is already in the Bible. And we should be happy because the time is near. But that does not take the responsibility out of our hands that we are to collect as much souls as we can for the kingdom of God. And I believe that the only way that we can do that is by, you know, by the mighty name of Jesus Christ and repenting of our sins. It is the way, it is the requirement. The requirement is that you repent, that I repent, that we get baptized, that we recognize that God gave his only begotten son so that we may have life, and that the precious lamb was sacrificed for us for our sins, and that in itself it is a very beautiful, unique act of love, real love, for him to have given his life for us. If you do not know love, that is love. And for his blood to continue to pay the price for us, for our sins, for our pleasure. It is time for your sake to repent. And I say this to myself, and I say this to others, because I know the struggle. I know it's real, and I know that we all as Christians have the possibility of falling tomorrow if we are not careful, if we are not humble, if we do not recognize our imperfection. We become easy target and open doors for our own failures. I'm not perfect, but in Jesus Christ, and because of Jesus Christ, I have the opportunity to become perfect in his image, because greater is he who is in me than he who is in the world. It's a long video because it has a lot to say, but at the same time, I don't have much to say. I posted this video because I had this dream, and I feel as if this dream is important, and it is heavily, you know, on my mind daily and heart, and I feel like, okay, it's something that I need to do. Whether it is prophetic or not, I do not know, but I can tell you that these things I saw is perhaps things to come, and I don't know the meaning of them, but if my job was to have a dream and share it, I did just that right now. For what purpose, I will not know, but perhaps I get the opportunity and chance to know. Now is the time to seek the Lord, because there will be a time where we won't be able to find him. Now is a time to get prepared. But as you get prepared, always remember that the only thing you'll be able to carry is the Lord. You know, if you have to suddenly get up and run, you'll have the Lord with you. So even though you need water and you need food and you need shelter, a time is here that you perhaps will be deprived of absolutely all of that, whether it happens suddenly or it happens in time. Preparation truly and really is for you to know how to pray, and the importance of prayer. And always remember that God asks us to look after our neighbors as we would ourselves. So we are responsible for our own salvation, just as it's true. But at the same time, we are also responsible for making sure that our brothers and sisters do not perish and go to hell, but that they have the same opportunity that we were presented with, that of salvation. And salvation is found in the name of Jesus Christ. Have a blessed day, and I hope that this helps someone. I believe I am a watchman, and the blood of the people can easily end up in my hands if I am not careful to warn the people of the time when I see the times ahead. So I say, prepare yourself, and preparation to me is to pray, believe. You have to have faith, you know, you have to know that God is real, and that truth is not shakable. You have to know that it is possible that you will be beheaded for the name of Jesus Christ, that you might find yourself in that moment where you have to choose to live here and die, or die here and live forever in the kingdom of God.